his brand of baseball with the Yankees. And when I signed with the Yankees, came up to New York and got on the field when I was 17 years old. I lived a fantasy, and I knew from that day on that this city was going to be my city.
And even the Stage Deli named a sandwich after you, the late lamented Stage Deli. What was in the sandwich?
Let me tell you what it was. It was corned beef, pastrami, and chopped liver. And unfortunately, I didn't like chopped liver, but I didn't have a queso in it. And, you know, but the worst part, Eddie, it was in existence for 75 years. And now it's gone. Now I got to find another deli in the city that they're going to have a sandwich after me, because it was myself and Orchinsky, and we're the only two Jews. A baseball player had a sandwich named after him at the stage, so it's great.
You've never been shy, and you do like to talk, and you, maybe that inside the sandwich they would have had tongue.
Wow, thank you.
You would think.
I don't like tongue either.
Yeah.
you know that I'm shy. I've known you for 40 years, and that's why our conversations are so good, because being an introvert like I am, and you are an introvert, so we know we got a small conversation together.
But based on your opening remarks, and of course, if you'd like to talk to Ron Bloomberg about the designated hitter, we welcome your calls on the toll free at 877-337-6666. But from your opening remarks, you didn't think this was going to work, did you?
No, I thought it was, to be honest with you, Eddie, I thought this is basically a glorified pinch hitter. You know, back in 73, the American League adopted it because they needed attendance and they needed some more run production. I thought it was a joke, to be honest with you. Whoever knew, to be honest with you, that, you know, there was going to be a glorified pinch hitter that's going to be in existence for 40 years. I remember when I stepped at the plate up in Boston, and we lost against Louis Tiant. Mel Stoudemire was pitching 15-5, and it was 34 degrees. We're in the clubhouse. It was like 35 degrees that game, and you know, and there was about 60, 70 reporters coming up to me, looking at me, and they said, "How was it to be the first DH ever in the game of baseball?" I looked at them. I said, "Hey, it's going to last 30 days. It's going to be a one-and-done thing. But look at it now. It's 40 years. You know, I mean, I screwed up the game of baseball. It's been wonderful. And, you know, to be able to be out of baseball for 30-something years, to be able to talk to people like yourself and to be friends and to come up to New York City and all the people that will come up to me and talk to me, this is great. I love the people here, and I love you."
Well, they love you, too, and all our lines are going. Here's Jamie in West Haven for Ron Bloomberg. Jamie, thanks for Ed Randall's talking baseball.
Thank you so much, Ron. It's a pleasure talking to you.
Great talking to you.
I got a great story for you, Ron. I used to be the bat boy for the West Haven Yankees in 1979. Had a great team with Bertani, Billy McGee. Scott Merrill was the manager back then. But, our uniforms were hand-me-downs to the New York Yankees. And I got your pants. My mother had those your pants. They were so thick. I was only 13 years old. And it said, bring the back to this believer. And my shirt that I had, number 15, it said Munson on it. It was just an unbelievable thing. I'm a diehard Yankee fan. I quit with you when I was a little kid. Jim Ray Park was another teenager back then, but you were the first. And it's an honor to talk to you and be a Yankee fan.
Well, it's great to be able to talk to you and people like yourself. People don't realize, people like yourself, you are the heroes of the game of baseball. And to be able to play with you and to play where you can watch me and the ears of Boo and whatever, you are
the dugout. What did you do?
It was terrible because, I mean, being a pinch hitter, you know that being a pinch hitter, okay, maybe 8th or 9th inning. So, you know, whenever we hit, you know, I had no idea, of course, what to do because I was on first base. Dustin Howard was first base coach.